Morning, welcome back. So in the last lecture we have seen that every 2 by 2 system is linearly equivalent to one of the three types that depends on the eigenvalues of the matrix. If the system matrix has two real and distinct eigenvalues, then the given matrix can be diagonalized. And if the matrix is has a real but double eigenvalue, then it goes to a form of the type lambda 1 0 lambda, and the third type corresponds to the complex eigenvalues. And we also had the detailed analysis of the type 1, where the eigenvalues are real and distinct, and the system corresponds to what is called the equilibrium point, is what is called a knot. And if the eigenvalues lambda mu, the product of the eigenvalues is positive, and the product of the eigenvalues lambda mu is negative, then it is called a saddle point equilibrium. And that is a unstable equilibrium. When lambda mu greater than 0 and both the eigenvalues are positive, then the equilibrium point is unstable. And if lambda, both lambda and mu are negative, then the eigenvalues, then the corresponding equilibrium point is stable. So that is a type 1 analysis completely. Now we will quickly go to the type 2 and type 3. So we will go to the type 2 type. So type 2. So the type 2, there are two cases when B1 is of the form, B1 is equal to lambda 0. 0 lambda. This is the case in the type 2. There are two cases, namely case 1 here, case 1, where the eigenvalue is a double eigenvalue, but it has two independent eigenvectors. In this case, and of course, lambda not equal to 0, this situation is absolutely no difference. It is exactly like type 1, where you can write down so lambda equal to 1, and it is like a node. So the equilibrium point is a node. Equilibrium point is a node, exactly like in the previous year, previous class of the case type 1, and absolutely no different. It is stable if lambda positive, lambda negative. It is unstable if lambda positive. The solution can easily be written as, in this case, x1 t is equal to x 0 1 into e power lambda t, and x2 t is equal to x 0 2 e power lambda t, same lambda. So this, if you eliminate t, you will get x1 is equal to a constant into x2. So it is nothing but straight lines all the time. So if you have the phase portrait here, you have the origin as an equilibrium point. X1 equal to x2 is nothing but a straight line. And so if you have this is the case. So if you start any point here, and if this is the situation when lambda negative, it will be stable. So it will move along that, and it will, this is the, so any point you start, it will be completely like this. Wherever you start, the it is a straight line. So the entire trajectories are given like that, like this it will go. So that is a phase portrait for lambda less than 0. If lambda greater than 0, I will draw it in the same thing. If lambda greater than 0, it is the same thing if you start with, but then it will move away from that. So this is the for t negative part. From here, if you start, so if you start anywhere, it will move along the straight line. This is the point t negative part, so it will move along this straight line. So trajectories are straight lines. So if you start from here again, yeah, so if you start from
this is the starting point. From starting point, it will go along this straight line.
So you will have instability. This is a phase portrait. Phase portrait of two systems. Okay, it's not just one. For lambda less than 0, you have the complete. So, phase portraits for lambda greater than 0, you have your unstable thing, that is nothing completely R2, and for lambda less than 0, it is a completely stable, there is no instability or instability. So, you have the complete EU is equal to the stable subspace and unstable subspace are given like that. Okay. So, there is nothing. Now, we will go to the case 2, case 2. In the case 2, if you do, again it behaves exactly like the node case. So, there are not real difference between type 2 and type 1 when the real distinct taken values. Okay. So, only thing in the type 1, when lambda mu less than 0, it is a saddle point equilibrium. That's only difference, otherwise it is a node. So, for this case, so the B2 is of this form lambda 1 0 lambda. So, the corresponding system is x1 dot is equal to lambda x1 plus x2 and the x2 dot is equal to lambda x2. So, the lambda for x2 is an independent thing. So, you can solve for you can solve this system separately if you prefer, because if x2 can be solved immediately because it is a decoupled part. Once you find the x2, you can put it here for x1, and that is a non-homogeneous system for x1. Otherwise, you can immediately compute. So, here is an exercise for you to compute now. This is an exercise, one should do it immediately. You for this matrix, for diagonal matrix, you already know if it is a diagonal entries lambda 1 etcetera lambda n e power, the whole thing is the computation of exponential. So, if it is a diagonal matrix, the diagonal entries will be e power lambda. But how does it look like if for a B2? So, that is where the exercise. So, you compute your B2 square, B2 cube etcetera. And then you compute e power b2. This computation is easy. Told you we are doing this because the computation is not easy for us, and also for general matrix does not reveal the trajectory. So, this you can compute to see that e power b2 is e power lambda 1 1 0 1. And also compute, because we are interested in writing the solution, you also compute t b2, t square b2 square, t cube b2 cube, etcetera, and write down e power t b2. This exercise is not hard, you just have to do it familiar. You get e power t lambda into the matrix will be 1 here, t will be here, 0 will be, 1 will be here. So, you can write down now the solution immediately, because you can write down the solution. So, your solution will be, so you can do it either computing e power b2 or you can directly solve for this system. So, your solution xt will be for this system e power t b2 into x0. So, if you decouple that difference, so you will get x1t is equal to immediately, you can decouple it x0, x01. So, you will write down your solution x01, you can do the computation x02, the initial values of t e power t lambda, x2t is equal to x01. Because it is an independent of that. So, x1 will not come there, x02 into e power t lambda. So, you see, so this will go to plus or minus infinity if lambda positive, as t tends to infinity. This will go to 0 if lambda less than 0.
This is the same case for this also. This will go to plus or minus infinity. If lambda positive, this will go to 0. So you will have stability if lambda. So it's again the 0 is called a node. It's exactly like that, called a node. The only difference is that because of the appearance of this term, when you plot the trajectory in the neighborhood, it may have a different behavior, but then there is a t here. This will go to infinity, the effect of x to rho 1 will be wiped out. So you will see, so eventually it will be behave like this term because of the t. So if you plot the solution here, so for in a typical case, if you face portrait, if you do, if you start here, in the neighborhood there will be a twist because of the term like this, I told you. So I the exercise again is to plot these curves in the properly. So you may, if you start with the trajectory for lambda less than 0, may come, if you start with initially there will be some twist, it may behave like that, it will go to the origin if you start here. So from here, if you start it may, so it will go to 0 if for the lambda case, so it will be something like that. There may be some trajectory, there may be some trajectory difference of twisting because of the neighborhood of the origin, there will be, but eventually it will go to the origin. On the other hand, for lambda positive, if you want to see the lambda positive case, the trajectory will be the same, but then it may, if you start from here, the trajectory may go like this. The same behavior is will be there. If you start it, only thing it will go to infinity. It may, it depends on the initial values. So in the neighborhood there may be a motion difference, but eventually either it will go to 0 along a curve given by this x1t and x2t. It is given by the parametric representation x1t x2t, it will go to 0 as lambda less than 0, and it will go to infinity, plus infinity or minus infinity, from which quadrant you are starting with and the behavior of that one. So basically it depends on the this here, the sign of that. So it is a case of node. So the type 2 is exactly one case of type 1 in the node situation. So again, the equilibrium point in all these situations we call a node, and this node is stable if lambda positive negative, and it is unstable situation, unstable if lambda positive. So that completes the situation of type 2. So you have the your type 3. You have your eigenvalues, lambda is equal to a plus ib, lambda bar is equal to a minus ib, and your matrix b4 is equal to a minus b b a. This is the case. So your exercise will be to compute for this special type of the general matrix, it is difficult. The matrices we came upon is easy to compute. So I want you to compute as an exercise e power b 4, that is what our always the job will be, e power a, the computation will be cos of b minus sin of b, it will be sin of b cos of b. This is your e power b, but we are interested in e power t b 4, so you have to compute this one. If you compute this one, you will get e power t a, and matrix will be cos power b t minus sin b t, sin b t and cos b t. You can directly compute b4 square b4 cube b etcetera, or t b 4 etcetera. Another way to compute, probably this is, then maybe it is easy to compute, you can just try. If lambda is equal to a plus ib, you can actually see that a power k you have to compute. No, a not a plus I b. You will have b4 power k will be, please check this, the validity of this one, it will be real part of lambda power k minus imaginary part of lambda power k, imaginary part of lambda power k, real part of lambda power k. That is why you get it cos b, if you add it before power of factorial, you exactly get cos b t sin b t etcetera. You can do it, that one b4 with the thing, you have to work with the t b4, so correspondingly there will be t here. So you can do this thing exactly. Okay. Yeah. So with that you can write down your solution now. So what is the system corresponding to this one? Corresponding system in y system is y1 dot is equal to ay1 minus by2 and y2 dot is equal to by1 plus ay2. And if you write your solution for this system, solution yt is equal to e power t b4 y0. So we already computed e power t b4, so it will be e power t a into cos b t minus sin b t sin b t cos b t acting upon some y naught. So you have a representation of the solution. We want to see the phase portrait. The aim is to understand the phase portrait. So let us denote, for the time being, denote C is this matrix. C is the matrix cos bt minus sin bt sin bt cos bt. So this is the exercise part. Therefore your solution yt is in a short form, we are at e power ta c y naught, where c is this is a temporary notation. So what here, to understand the phase portrait, that is what you have to understand now. As t tends to infinity, look at these terms here, depending on the sine of a, depending on the sine of a, e power t a will go to plus infinity or minus infinity. If a is negative, t power t a will go to 0. If a is positive, t power a will go to infinity. If a is on the other hand, what will this is doing? This term cos and sin are periodic with period 2 pi, cos t and sin t are. So this shows the second term here, when act on y naught, shows some rotation, because as t tends to infinity, these terms, this action of this c y naught, if you start with the point y naught, it will rotate around the origin, that is what c will do. So c, on the action of c on y naught, will try to rotate around the origin. On the other hand, the term t power t a, if a not equal to 0, and that will either, that is typically the amplitude, if a is positive, e power t a will go to infinity. So it will start rotating, but rotation, the radius of the rotation will start increasing if a is positive, because that is amplitude. If a is negative, that will it will go to 0, the amplitude. So the e power t a will give you the amplitude of the rotation. This will give you the periodic rotations around that point. So we have to distinguish the case, two cases, when a not equal to 0 and a equal to 0. Because when a equal to 0, e power t a will vanish and there is only a pure rotation. There is no amplitude change, leading to what is called the periodic solution. You will, would be studying these things in the nonlinear analysis more, looking for periodic solutions of the trajectory. So we will consider in this case two cases, case with the
B with A not equal to 0. Of course, recall that, of course, B is always not equal to 0 in type 3, because if B equal to 0, then there is no complex part, there is no imaginary part, the eigenvalues are just real, and the real case we have already studied. So, of course, B is always not equal to 0 in type 3, because we are in the situation of complex eigenvalue. So, we will start with a case A not equal to 0. This leads to 4 cases according to the sign of cases according to the sign of A and B. So, what are the 4 possibilities coming into picture? So, let us try to understand one by one the case 1. So, we will have 2 cases first we plot. Let us plot the case when A positive. When A is positive, the amplitudes are increasing. So, if you are starting from any point here, it will rotate, but then rotation can take place either it will rotate in such a way that the amplitude should become bigger and bigger in both cases, because then, but the only thing is that whether it will rotate clockwise or anti-clockwise. So, there are 2 options for A positive. The rotation can take place in the clockwise direction, and the rotation can take place in the anti-clockwise direction. So, what the exercise I am going to suggest here, you try to take, if you want to say whether clockwise or anti-clockwise, what is the sign you have to choose, you start with some particular values of B and also particular values of A. So, consider 2 specific situations, choose some B say equal to 1 and choose A equal to 1, and then you take B equal to minus 1, A equal to 1 and all that possibilities, you try to see that rotation how it take place. To see that one specific case, if you want to see, let us take the case for, I want to know that the rotation amplitude is going to infinity. So, what will happen is that if you think that one go so one possibility is that it will take an anti-clockwise direction and the amplitude will go, but that is the case. So, your arrow will be something like that. The other situation, if you take this again, the amplitude is increasing, the clockwise it can go. So, you see it is going to infinity. So, this is your situation with y naught. This is the y naught here. The only thing is that one will be for B negative, one will be for B positive. The best way to check is that you consider a specific case, for example, with B positive. What will happen to that? If you want to check here, say choose B equal to 1. So, your matrix is cos t minus sin t cos t. This is the way you have to look at it. And look at see the vector which is starting from 1, 0. So, I am choosing a vector from here. I am choosing a vector from here, or you can see that vector from there. It is choosing. And what will happen this one? This will be, suppose I take t equal to 0. That is a situation when t equal to initial point is at the origin. So, when t equal to 0, cos 0 is equal to 1, sin 0 is equal to 0, 0. So, it will be 1, 0, 0, 1. So, it will go to 1, 0 only at t equal to 0. Where it will happen, suppose I am taking a rotating pi by 2. Taking t equal to pi by 2 at a later time. When t equal to pi by 2, cos pi by 2 is equal to 0 now, sin pi by 2 is equal to minus 1, and sin pi by 2 is equal to minus 1, which I want you to see that, that is equal to, and this is 1, 0, it will move to 0, 1, if you compute. So, what will happen is that, if I start from here, I will have my situations here. This is with, if I rotate here, next point will be, it will take this point y naught. If I start y naught from here,
it will go along this one. It increases. So this is the situation with B positive clockwise, and this is the situation B negative. So now this is the case with A positive. Now you can verify when two more cases will come. What are the two cases? Both these cases are with A negative. In this case again the same thing, you will get a clockwise rotation, you will get a clockwise rotation if you start, but then the amplitudes are reducing, so it should go towards the origin. So it will come here like this in the use. So this is the situation with B positive. Then if you start from here, if you start from here, see it will go to the origin, the spiraling. So this is A negative with B negative, this is A positive with A negative with B positive. So to see, of course we are taking A minus B, B A, that is a matrix we consider. Certain places you may take this also may be written in the form of A B minus B A, but you have to check the sign properly, look for thing. So the exercise is, the best exercise is that take some particular values of A and B with the different all the four combinations and try to focus here. So and this situation is called focus. So we will have, this is called the focus. Okay, it's a stable focus. In all these situation, all these four situation, we call the equilibrium point a focus, and stable if A negative. So it is depending on the real part of the eigenvalue. The stability always depend on the real part of the eigenvalue, not about the complex part. The sign of complex part determine the orientation of the trajectory. Okay, so you have a two focus is unstable in the first situation, first two figures, and it is stable in the next two figures. So we have left with one more case with A equal to 0. Case now, the last case which we want is case with A equal to 0. In this case the eigenvalues are purely imaginary and your solution yt is nothing but, you see, cos bt minus sin bt, sin bt cos bt. It is a pure rotation, it will rotate, pure rotation. Again, so there it is always compact if you have the trajectory. So if you are trying to do a phase portrait here and you have equilibrium point, it will only thing is that it will rotate like this. The other situation which you get is that it will rotate like this. That is only two possibility. Again it, you have to see that which direction it will see. This is the clockwise direction. With the earlier case we have already seen that. So you, okay, so you have this situation. So you have, so you see this is a B case, positive case you have an clockwise, and B negative you have anti clockwise. So you have, so you have, this is the case with B positive and this is the case B negative. Such a point here 0 is called a center, called a center. Center. So with A non-zero it is a focus in the complex situation, when A equal to 0 it is a center.
the equilibrium point is called like center completely. So, that giving in 2 by 2 systems, we have a complete analysis of this one. Okay. So, let me give a definition finally. Consolidating all the results, we will write the definition. For a 2 by 2 system, for a 2 by 2 system, any system 1, system 1, what is the one system? Let me recall, x dot is equal to ax. The equilibrium point, the equilibrium point zero is called 1 saddle point, 1 if lambda mu negative. Note here that the moment lambda mu is negative, it cannot be complex eigenvalues. Okay. So, it is automatically it tells you that it is eigenvalue. 2, n naught if lambda mu real, here you have to say it is real, and lambda mu positive. Lambda mu positive because if lambda mu even in the complex case will be real, even if lambda and mu are complex, because lambda will be a plus ib, mu will be a minus ib, and hence lambda mu will be a square plus b square. Yeah, okay. So, it is always positive, and it is unstable if lambda positive, mu positive, stable if lambda negative, both the eigenvalues are negative. Okay. And third situation, the equilibrium point is a focus, called a focus, if lambda mu complex with real part of lambda, both real part of lambda is not equal to 0, because real part of lambda is not equal to 0, and that is also a condition, stable if real part of lambda is negative, unstable if real part of lambda is positive. The last case for a center, if the same thing, lambda mu complex with the real part of lambda equal to 0. You see, so you have a in other words, purely imaginary. That is what, pure imaginary. Okay. So, we have a complete analysis of the 2 by 2 system. There is an interesting bifurcation diagram. We will end this 2 by 2 part before going to high dimension. There is a bifurcation diagram, nice bifurcation diagram. So, you can get a picture. This bifurcation diagram is in the bifurcation diagram. This is in determinant trace space, determinant trace plane. What do I mean by that determinant trace plane? Given a thing, you given a matrix, you can write determinant of A is nothing but the product of eigenvalues. Let me call it, this is to delta by definition, and then you call it alpha, the trace of A, that is nothing but the sum of eigenvalues. Then you know that clearly, because this is the product and this is the sum, and it solves a second order algebraic equation. So this would be in the coefficient of the power term. So the eigenvalues satisfy the eigenvalues satisfy the quadratic equation, right? Quadratic equation z square minus alpha z, that's a sum of the eigen, because it's a roots, so it's a coefficient of that, plus delta equal to 0. So you can write your lambda mu as, solve that equation, lambda mu, the eigen values can be written in terms of the determinant and the trace, that is equal to alpha plus or minus square root of alpha square minus 4 delta by 2. You see, so you can write your alpha is, one is the alpha plus square root of alpha minus 4 delta by 2, and the other one is alpha minus square root of alpha square minus. So I am going to draw the diagram in the plane, determinant by this is alpha, that is nothing but the trace, and this is delta, delta is equal to lambda mu, and this is equal to lambda plus 1. So this is nothing but alpha is equal to lambda plus mu. So what is this? So let us consider all the cases. So below this domain, below the x alpha axis, delta, so this is the region delta less than 0, delta is equal to lambda mu less than 0. So what is this region? This region is this region, the complete region, complete negative region. On that you have all four points for lambda mu satisfy, it belongs to this region, that means delta less than 0. So you have your saddle point here, so you have your saddle, you have your saddle point, this is the saddle point, this region saddle point. Now let us look at the situation here when these eigenvalues are real eigenvalue. It is real, so you have lambda mu real if alpha square minus 4 delta greater than or equal to 0. So you have to consider the equation and complex if alpha square minus 4 delta less than 0. So in the alpha delta plane, alpha square minus 4 delta equal to 0 determines a parabola. So you have to draw the parabola here now. You have to draw the parabola here. So you have your parabola here, and this is nothing but the region alpha square minus 4 delta equal to 0. And what it shows that, so you have a different thing. This is the region alpha square minus 4 delta positive, this is also the region alpha square minus 4 delta positive. Here is alpha square minus 4 delta negative, and here alpha square minus 4 delta negative. Okay. So that gives. Now consider this case again. On that case, when alpha square minus 4 delta greater than or equal to 0, one eigenvalue here with the plus sign here will remain to be positive. So one of the eigenvalues minus that will be negative, because alpha square. So if you look at here alpha square, this region, if you look at all this region corresponding to this one, alpha square minus 4 delta positive, you will have the stable focus, unstable. In this case it will be unstable, unstable. Here is a region with node, so you have unstable node, because it is a situation where you have real eigenvalues, so you have only node.
Here also is a situation, it is a node thing, but then you have the other thing and you will have your stable eigenvalue here. So you will have this stable here, stable node. You see, so this is the situation alpha square minus, both are nodes, but here you look at it, here it is alpha is equal to with alpha positive, and this is the region with this part is the region with this part is the region with alpha negative. So you will get your eigenvalues in this region, both eigenvalues will be negative in this region if you look at it. Similarly, if you look at here, you will get unstable focus, and you here you will get a stable focus. Okay. So you have to understand that this is a region, this entire region is where delta is equal to lambda mu positive. So you will have a region here, delta lambda mu positive with lambda plus mu positive, that gives you both lambda and mu are positive, and here you will get the stability. What about this here, this region, this line? On that line you will see that the real part is 0, the real part is 0. So that is a region where you have center, you see. So this is the region. So this gives you in the delta alpha plane a complete analysis of the you have your complete analysis of the thing. Okay. So this portion, the first quadrant is the unstable situation quadrant. Of course, the third and fourth are already unstable because of the saddle point equilibrium. The first quadrant is unstable, and this is called the source. And second quadrant is stable part. This is called the sink. See, everything will sink there. So this gives you a complete, you do not have to think in a determinant trace plane, you can completely understand where your stability and instability is happening, where it is saddle point, where it is node, where it is focus, where it is thing. So that gives you the a complete picture. Of course, we are in an easy situation of 2 by 2 and hence you have the complete picture. Such a picture in general is much more harder when you go to the higher dimensional situation. So we will now try to give some interesting one or two examples and before going to higher dimensional situation. So we will at least give two examples. So here is an example one, we will have more examples later. One example is a situation where your eigenvalues are, previous thing, there is one more thing. Where is the picture here? This is the situation, this case, let me have a different color. This is the case where you have the degeneracy. You see, this is a situation where determinant is 0, which is a kind of degenerate situation, is a degenerate. You will have the degenerate case. That is a region, that is what we skipped. So that is a day. So we will see an example of the next one. So consider an example with a matrix A is equal to 0, 0, 0, minus 2. So what are the eigenvalues? Eigenvalues are lambda equal to 0 and mu equal to minus 2. So we want to determine, of course, x equal to 0 for any linear system, the origin is an equilibrium point. But if A is invertible, origin is the only equilibrium point,
because the equilibrium points are given by Ax equal to 0, set of all x such that Ax equal to 0. So, if invertible, only x equal to 0 is the solution to that one, but here is a case determinant of A not equal to 0. Determine, this is a case determinant, sorry, determinant of A equal to 0. So, you have to look for what are all Ax equal to 0. You want to find all the equilibrium point. Ax equal to 0 immediately will give you x, the second component, this is x1, x2, the second component is 0, that is all you give. First component, it does not give you anything, because the equation say x equal to 0 is equivalent to 0 x1 plus 0 x2 is equal to 0. Second one is 0 x1 minus 2 x2 equal to 0. So, that show x2 equal to 0. That means every point on the x axis, the x1 axis, every point on the x1 axis is an equilibrium point. It does not put Ax equal to 0, does not put any conditions on the first component of x. That implies any point, every point on the x1 axis is an equilibrium point, you see. So, equilibrium point. So, now I want to solve this equation. So, what are the equations? You do not have the equation. The first equation, the is equal to x1 dot is equal to 0, because Ax equal to 0 implies x equal to 0, x2 dot is equal to minus 2 x2. So, if you solve this equation, you will get x1 dot is, x1 t is a constant, that nothing but a constant is the initial point, and x2 t is equal to x02 into e power minus 2 t, you see. So, what does this shows that? Now, if you are trying to find a, this is nothing but an equation of a line, but it is an equation of a perpendicular line. So, that is why it cannot be written as a function of x1 variable anyway, x1, this is x2. So, what I am trying to say is that every point on this is an equilibrium point, all the points are equilibrium point, not just the origin, all points are equilibrium points. And what does this say that, so if I start a point from here x0, what does this say that if the first component, this x1 trajectory says that the first component will not change. So, this will be your x01, this will be your x02. So, if you start from here, the first component will not change, and the second component says that it will go to the same x0, it will go to the 0, this goes to 0 as t tends to infinity. So, the second component goes to 0 and x component will not change, it will remain. If it does not change, it has to come along this one. So, it will move along this one. So, whenever you start here, the trajectory will move here as t tends to infinity. If you start from here, it will move to that. Anywhere you start, it will go towards that, because x2 component. So, all your trajectories are given like this, all whatever your trajectory you start, it will move towards that. So, this is the complete phase portrait of this system, phase portrait, okay. Yes. So, in other words, starting from x01, x02 at time t equal to 0, the trajectory moves towards only at infinity, moves towards x01 origin along the perpendicular line, along the perpendicular line. you see the behavior difference in that one. Okay. So we'll go to another example, how the linear transformation, linear equivalence example will change. So you will start with a system which is not in its normal form. So you consider a system. Consider a system. Let me write down x1 dot is equal to. So part of it is an exercise also, minus equal to minus x1 minus 3x2, and x2 dot is equal to your 2x2. So your matrix A is nothing but minus 1 minus 3 0 2. This is your A. Here is an exercise for you. So let me put it in a different color, the exercise. The show that the eigenvalues are clear. Eigenvalues immediately known. Eigenvalues are lambda equal to minus 1, mu is equal to 2. With eigenvectors, find the eigenvectors. With eigenvectors, with eigenvectors 1, 0, minus 1, 1. Therefore, the matrix P, which converts to a linear equivalent matrix, because these are two distinct eigenvalues, so you immediately get as it's a 1, 0, minus 1, 1. Compute P inverse. Compute P inverse. P inverse is nothing but 1, 1, 0, 1. And that will give you your B equal to P inverse of AP, that's of the form minus 1, 0, 0, 2. You see? And that's a diagonal system as expected, because you have two distinct eigenvalues and hence you will have thing. So, what is a Y system? Therefore, your Y system is Y dot is equal to AY. That's already we have studied. It's a standard problem which an saddle point equilibrium, now it's clear, because you have two real eigenvalues with opposite signs and hence it is a saddle point equilibrium. So you can write down, which we have done already, the solutions. So if you plot this curve here, immediately I don't want to go further here to you can do that one. So if you plot your y, this is for the y axis, this is your y1, this is your y2. And this also says that the first eigenvalue, the corresponding to the first eigenvalue minus 1, and you have the first component stability, the second component instability, total instability, but then it is a saddle point equilibrium. You will have this one. So, this is your phase portrait, your phase portrait, and y2 go to infinity and y1 go to 0. So, y1 go to 0 means, so your graph will be like this. So, y1 will go to 0, you see, it will go to 0, this will go to 0. So, this is, so this is your phase portrait of that, and it is an invertible matrix. So, now, we want to know the solution corresponding to x1. You can of course take do the analysis, because you can write down from here e power at, you can write down a is nothing but p b p inverse, you can write down the solution, and then your solution is, you can write down as e power t a is equal to e power p t a of x naught is nothing but p b p inverse of x naught. So you choose this p inverse of x naught as y naught. So this is starting with that p b of y naught. And PB, you can write down the solution completely, immediately. So, the solution is XT is equal to e power TA of X naught is nothing but P, you can completely compute, B is the diagonal matrix. So, it will be e power minus T, 0, 0, e power 2T of P inverse, we already computed. So, this is your solution. So, you have your solution completely. you can plot it separately, but then let us try to understand the transformation in this slide itself, so that we do not need another slide. So, what is your transformation going? So, your transformation y going to x equal to p y or p, x equal to p y, this we already discussed. So, you compute that one. If you do that transformation, how does my axis, I told you in the beginning, this kind of transformation linear equivalence is the coordinate change. So, I want to know that how does my y 1 coordinate changes. So, I want to first compute p of 1 0. If you compute p of 1 0, you just take p is equal to 1 0, is nothing but 1 0 itself. So, the x y 1 coordinate axis goes to x 1 axis itself. But what about my second coordinate axis, p of 0 1, the y 2 axis, and the y 2 axis, you can see that it is minus 1 1, that is what it will go to 0. So, if you plot, so that if you, so if you now try to sketch my in the x 1 x 2 plane, the if I sketch the x 1, the y 1 axis go to your x 1 axis. So, I will plot here. So, let me choose a proper color. So, if you, it will, you see, it will go to the same color, but then the x 2 axis goes to p 0 1 goes to minus 1 to 1. So, it will go to this axis, it, that is what the y 1 minus y 2 plane. So, it will go to this plane. So, this is the new coordinates now. This is y, this is the coordinate y 1 plus y 2 equal to 0, or x 1 plus x 2 equal to 0. You see, that is where it goes. So, the y 2 axis actually transforms this one. So, now the trajectories do not intersect. So, the trajectory corresponding to this one, if you take it, it will go like this. So, the trajectories will be like this, and the corresponding trajectories will be, the even the directions will not change it. So, the directions will be like this. Okay. See, the trajectory here, it will be only shrinking. So, the saddle point equilibrium. So, this will be the trajectories in the, so that is the trajectories here, and this is the trajectories here. So, this will all will be unstable. The second component is unstable, the first component is stable. So, still you get the stability here. This will be in this direction, you know, there is not, we are not talking about that. So, okay. So, this will be here and this is direction. So, this is the phase portrait. Phase portrait of the solution, phase portrait of the solution. So, that gives you, that is what in the beginning I have told, under linear equivalence, under this thing, the trajectory behavior, the equilibrium, the stability of the behavior do not change. Whatever stability you have, you will get the same thing. So, the picture something like will be changed to transformed into a new coordinate system. Okay. So, with this the we will stop the complete 2 by 2 part. Now, we will not be able to do such a detailed analysis for the higher dimensional system, but we will appeal to the Jordan decomposition. What are the best possible things we can do it in higher dimension. We will begin with one or two examples and possible ideas behind it, and then we will see what are the blocks coming in higher dimensional system in the next lecture. Thank you.